Hello, friend, and welcome to the Internet, the guiding light and deadly laser in our hectic modern world. The Internet Horde has been watching you closely for some time now. It has seen you flock to your Facebook and your Twitter over the years, and it has seen you enter its home turf and attempt to overrun it with your scandals and real-world gossip. You need to know that the ownership of cyberspace will always remain with the hive mind. The Internet does not belong to your beloved authorities, militaries, or multi-millionaire company owners. The Internet belongs to the trolls and the hackers, the enthusiasts and the extremists. It will never cease to be this way. You see, the Internet has long since lost its place in time, and its shady collective continues to shun the fact that it lives in a specific year like 2012, where it has to abide by 2012's morals and 2012 society with its rules and its punishments. The Internet smirks at scenes of mass rape and horrific slaughtering, followed by a touch of cannibalism, all to the sound of catchy Japanese music. It simply doesn't give a tuppence about getting a job, getting a car, getting a house, raising a family, and teaching them to continue the loop while the human race organizes its own death. Custom-plated coffins and retirement plans made of paperwork. The Internet asks, why? You cannot make the Internet feel bad. You cannot make the Internet feel regret or guilt or sympathy. You can only make the Internet feel the need to have more lulls at your expense. The lulls flow through all in the faceless army as they see the Twin Towers falling with a dancing Hitler on loop in the bottom left corner of their screens. The lulls strike when they open a newspaper and care nothing for any of the world's alleged problems. They laugh at downward red arrows as banks and businesses tumble, and they laugh at our glorious government overlords trying to fix a situation by throwing more currency at it. They laugh when you try to make them feel the need to make something of life. And they laugh harder when you call them vile trolls and heartless web terrorists. They laugh at you because you're not capable of laughing at yourselves and all of the pointless fodder they believe you surround yourselves in. But most of all, they laugh because they can. This is not to say that the Internet is your enemy. It is your greatest ally and closest friend. Its shops mean you don't have to set foot outside your home, and its casinos allow you to lose your money at any hour of the day. Its many chat rooms ensure you no longer need to interact with any other members of your species directly, and detailed social networking conveniently maps your every move and thought. Your intimate relationships and darkest secrets belong to the Horde, and they will never be forgotten. Your existence will forever be encoded into the infinite repertoire of beautiful, bite-sized sequences, safely housed in a cyber cloud for all to observe. And how has the Internet changed the lives of its most hardened addicts? They simply don't care enough to tell you. So welcome to the underbelly of society, the anarchistic stream of thought nebula that seeps its way into the mainstream world, your world, more and more every day. You cannot escape it, and you cannot anticipate it. It is the nightmare on the edge of your dreams and the ominous thought that claws its way through your online life like a blinding virtual force, disregarding your philosophies and feasting on your emotions. Prepare to enter the hive mind, motherfuck.
They are anonymous. The governments of the world have threatened them with persecution. Across Europe, NATO has inspired countries to hunt them down and arrest them, wherever they can be found. In the USA, there have been calls to treat Anonymous as terrorists, and it has even been suggested that they could be shot or bombed. But you cannot kill the desire for freedom and justice, and you cannot arrest an idea. Since the conception of Anonymous, they have been responsible for many operations around the world. From bringing internet access to the Egyptian people during their recent revolution, to opposing massive government agencies and corporations. While Anonymous is being pursued for alleged cybercrimes, their actions have brought justice to our world. Anonymous is not merely a group of hackers. Anonymous is an identity, it is the art of being indignant. It is the art of being one, yet being nothing. Behind the mask is more than flesh and blood, behind the mask is an idea, and ideas are bulletproof. Free topiary. Stop the persecution of Anonymous. Expect us.